We type the commands to instruct our robot what to do into a laptop, and we have to somehow get them into our EV3 robot. We do this by using a cable like this. The cable has two ends. It has a flat rectangular end, which looks like this, and a smaller end that looks like this. The larger flat end will go into the edge of your laptop, and you may have slots in the side of your laptop which look like these. Now, there are two flat rectangular ones here. That is an HDMI slot. That is not what we need. This is the rectangular one we need. Sometimes they're labeled USB. Usually not. We can plug that in there. And so that's got it nicely. We've got to now look for a hole in our EV3 robot that matches these. At one end of our EV3 robot, we have these four connectors. They're not what we need. They're the wrong shape. Look at the other end, and we'll find here one labelled PC, which is perfect. There's a long side and a short side to the connector, as you can see. The long side goes towards the screen side of the robot. Okay, so we've plugged that in, and there we have a connection between our laptop and our EV3 robot, and we can send commands through there. We'll learn how to do that in the next tutorial. Thank you. We want to teach our robot how to move. We go to LEGO Mindstorms EV3 Home Edition here. I double click on that, and LEGO Mindstorms software for EV3 starts up. We go to the File menu heading in the top left, left-click that, and then left-click on New Project. Now, this is the area where we would give the instruction that would teach our robot how to do something. This is the start of a list of instructions. The instructions we will use are down the bottom here. You'll notice as we click each of these, Flow Control, that goes up, we get and then sensor. Each we get a different set of instructions, a different set of icons each time we click that. We'll learn more about these later on. For this particular project, we only want to click on the action one, and we will go down to the fourth from the left, and we'll see move tank. We'll left click on that, and holding down the left mouse button, drag it up alongside that green arrow. And this is our first program, our first instruction to our robot. What does it say? We'll have a lot more about this later on, but we'll just say a little bit for this one. It says on for rotations. That means the command is for it to turn its wheels around, the wheels that are connected to the motor. One motor will be turning at 75% of full power, so will the other one. It will go, the motors will go one rotation, each wheel will go one rotation 360 degrees, and after it's done that, it will stop. And that's our complete command at this stage. So the next thing we've got to do is to download that to our robot. Now, if we go down here, you can see that EV3 has no brick connected. We will now have to start up the EV3 robot for it to be recognized by the system. Now, you may get a notice about updating the programmable bricks firmware version.